Thank you, Surjewalaji. I'd like to welcome all the Congress senior leaders, Siddharamaiya ji, Parmeshwar ji, Venugopal ji, Kharge ji, and all my friendly journalists. I'm looking forward to your questions. I'd just like to say a few words. I've been now traveling around Karnataka for a couple of months, and it's been an honor for me to travel in this state. I have learned a tremendous amount from the people of this state, from their spirit, from their perspective. The Congress Party has fought a very good campaign. We've all stood together. Our party is completely united, and we fought the campaign on the fundamental issues. And I think we've put down in front of Karnataka a vision for Karnataka. Our opposition has restricted itself to making personal attacks on the Chief Minister, on Kargeji, on myself and other leaders. They haven't really put down what they want to do for Karnataka. What the Congress wants to do for Karnataka is very, very clear. We made certain commitments, and we've delivered on those commitments, and now we have prepared a manifesto that is truly the voice of the people of Karnataka. Moiliji prepared that manifesto. He went all around the state, had meetings with thousands and thousands of people, and we pulled out the essence of what the people of Karnataka are looking for in the next 5 years. In contrast, the BJP built their manifesto in a closed room, 3-4 days, copied half of what we said. So there is a lack of seriousness among them about what they want to deliver for this state. And that, I think, is a huge difference. I'm very confident that the Congress Party is going to win the election here. Thank you.
Progress with Congress has been the theme of this election. Congress President and other leaders will now take questions. I would request that if you raise your hands, some friends have already done. I'll keep noting down and I'll keep coming to you. I'll send the mic to you. Also, when you start your question, if you can also identify yourself, it will be fine. We'll start with Shri Raman in the first row. Can you please pass on the mic?
Rahulji, Raman, News 24 se hoon. Kal Pradhan Mantri ne kaha ki Rahul Gandhi naamdar hain, main kaamdar hoon. Aur विपक्ष के नेताओं का अभी एक संगठन बना नहीं है, उससे पहले ही विपक्ष के इतने बड़े नेता हैं, उनसे बिना सलाह मशविरा किए उन्होंने प्रधानमंत्री पद का उम्मीदवार घोषित कर दिया। एक मुद्दा लगातार आप चुनाव प्रचार के दौरान भी कहते रहे हैं, कल भी हमने देखा कि जनसभा में आपने उठाया, हिंदुस्तान एरोनॉटिक्स लिमिटेड का हेड ऑफिस बेंगलुरु में है। एनडीए सरकार लगातार ये कह रही है कि राफेल के मुद्दे पे हमारी डील यूपीए से अच्छी हुई, लेकिन आप इस
नहीं उनकी डील यूपीए से अच्छी हुई, मगर किसके लिए? उनके मित्रों के लिए, हिंदुस्तान के लिए नहीं। मैं भी उस बात को मानता हूं कि राफेल की डील बीजेपी के नेताओं के लिए, नरेंद्र मोदी जी के लिए और उनके जो मित्र हैं, जो 45,000 करोड़ रुपए डेट में हैं, उनके लिए बेहतर डील थी। मगर हिंदुस्तान ने 700 करोड़ रुपए हवाई जहाज के लिए 1500 करोड़ दिए हैं, तो मैं उनसे सहमत हूं कि डील अच्छी है, मगर उनके लिए। जहां तक प्रधानमंत्री की बात है, यह कर्नाटका का चुनाव है और ये सब जो चीजें हैं ये डिस्ट्रैक्ट करने की चीजें हैं। यहां पे एक सवाल है, एक तरफ कांग्रेस पार्टी के नेता हैं, सिद्धरमैया जी बैठे हुए हैं, इनकी आप चेहरा देखिए, दूसरी तरफ येदुरप्पा जी बैठे हैं, दूसरी तरफ रेड्डी ब्रदर्स बैठे हैं। 35,000 करोड़ रुपए रेड्डी ब्रदर्स ने कर्नाटक की जनता से चोरी किया है, कंपैरिजन ही नहीं है। एक तरफ एक ईमानदार व्यक्ति जो प्रदेश के लिए काम करते हैं, दिल से काम करते हैं, दूसरी तरफ जेल में बैठे हुए, जेल से निकले हुए लोग। थोड़ा मैं अंग्रेजी में भी बोल देता हूं क्योंकि इट्स अ कर्नाटका इलेक्शन। वुड यू लाइक टू आस्क मी इन इंग्लिश?
Do you think Rafael issue is very big issue for Karnataka elections?
No, you've changed the wording. I like to be precise. You see, the wording you used was that the Prime Minister said it was a very good deal. And I agree with him. It was a very good deal. But it was a very good deal for the Prime Minister and his businessman friend, who is 45,000 crores in debt, who has never built an aeroplane in his life. They have taken away jobs from HAL, the youngsters of Karnataka, thousands and thousands of technical jobs of the highest value addition could have come to Karnataka. But Mr. Narendra Modi chose to give that deal to his friend. He didn't follow the procedure. He didn't ask the cabinet committee on security. He paid 1500 crores for a plane that the UPA had worked out at 700 crores. Of course, it's a great deal. It's a great, absolutely smashing deal for Mr. Narendra Modi. And you can see the effects of it in the amount of money they're throwing around in the state. And regarding the Prime Minister question, Mr. Narendra Modi likes to distract people. This election is nothing to do with Rahul Gandhi. This election is to do with the future of Karnataka. Mr. Narendra Modi has nothing to say about the future of Karnataka. So he likes to distract it, so I'm not going to engage in that distraction. Thank you.
Shri Arun Singh. I'm
noticed. Rahul ji, I'm Arun Singh, News 18 India, Delhi. एक सवाल मेरा है कि
अंग्रेजी में पूछेंगे
नहीं हिंदी में हिंदी चैनल है हमारा सर ठीक है सर आज सुबह प्रधानमंत्री ने खुद को गरीब बताते हुए कहा कि कांग्रेस पार्टी का दलितों से कोई लेना देना है नहीं सिर्फ वो उनके मुद्दे उठाते हैं और जो सबसे बड़ा उनका पॉलिटिकल प्लान
अरे कांग्रेस पार्टी को दलितों से कुछ लेना देना नहीं और सिर्फ वो उनके मुद्दे उठाते हैं
और
तो मुद्दे तो उठाते हैं हमारा ये सवाल है कि प्रधानमंत्री उनके मुद्दे क्यों नहीं उठा रहे हैं मतलब इस बार तो प्रधानमंत्री हमारी बात कर रहे हैं हमने कहा है कि दलितों को मारा जा रहा है पीटा जा रहा है कूटा जा रहा है दबाया जा रहा है रोहित वेमुला खड़ा होता है कहता है मुझे शिक्षा चाहिए उसको कुचल के मार दिया जाता है चिट्ठी जाती है उसको दबा दिया जाता है नरेंद्र मोदी जी के मुंह से एक शब्द नहीं निकलता है ऊना में दलितों को मारा जाता है नरेंद्र मोदी जी के मुंह से एक शब्द नहीं निकलता है उत्तर प्रदेश में मारा जाता है नरेंद्र मोदी जी के मुंह से शब्द नहीं निकलता है तो दलितों के मुद्दे हम तो उठाएंगे वो तो हमारा काम है
सर 2 करोड़ जॉब्स की पर आप सबसे ज्यादा हमला करते हैं
आई लाइक टू से दैट इन इंग्लिश आल्सो बिकॉज आई हैव गॉट अ कर्नाटका ऑडियंस एंड आई वांट टू से दैट वुड यू लाइक टू आस्क मी द क्वेश्चन इन इंग्लिश
प्राइम मिनिस्टर टुडे व्हाइल एड्रेसिंग एससी एसटी पीपल थ्रू नमो ऐप He said, accused Congress, they have nothing to do with Dalit and they are only garnering their votes. And also he alleged that your party is raising issues related to Dalits for Karnataka election. And he himself...
Now you have changed the question again. The question you asked me was, Mr. Narendra Modi said that the Congress party is only raising Dalit issues.
Yeah.
And I said, absolutely, that is our job. We will defend the rights of Dalits. We will raise Dalit issues. The question is, when Mr. Rohit Vemula is killed, Mr. Narendra Modi doesn't say a word. When people in Una are beaten, humiliated, our Prime Minister doesn't say a word. Our Prime Minister gives as much money in the whole of India to Dalits and tribals. Half of that money Karnataka government gives. Let me rephrase that. Karnataka government gives half of the money that the entire Indian government gives for Dalits and tribals. This is something for the Indian government to be ashamed of. Thank you.
Shri Nagarjun. Sorry. Shri Nagarjun was asking there.
Sir, Nagarjun from India Today here. Here. This way, sir. Okay, I can't see.
Okay, here.
Okay. So you've been speaking about in every rally about how it's Beti Bachao and BJP MLA se Bachao and PM Modi speaks about how it should not be politicized. You also held a candle march against Unnao and Kathua rape cases. Don't you think that you and your party are politicizing
against women, rapes of women is a political issue. Who says it's not a political issue? It's absolutely a national issue. Are you telling me that if India's women are raped, politicians shouldn't discuss it? It's absolutely a political issue. It is an issue that is fundamental. The treatment of our women, the treatment of 50% of our women is absolutely an issue. And Mr. Modi likes to discuss things like, you know, seaplanes, which is a political issue, I guess, bullet trains, but fundamental issues in Karnataka, he doesn't like to discuss. What are the issues in Karnataka? They're pretty simple. Helping the farmers. We have given 8,000 crore rupees to the farmers. How much money has the Prime Minister given? How much money has the Prime Minister given to the farmers of India and the farmers of Karnataka? I'd like to ask that question. He gives 250,000 crores to the richest 15 people in this country. I want to ask, if the government of Karnataka has given 8,000 crores, how many rupees has the Prime Minister of India given? Zero. Zero. He has not given one rupee in debt waiver to the farmers of India. This is something to be ashamed of. That is another political issue. But Mr. Narendra Modi doesn't like to raise it. Very fundamental political issue. Our Prime Minister comes and says he fights for corruption. Well, on his stage is Mr. Yedurappa, his chief ministerial candidate, who has spent time in jail. Let me repeat that. Who has spent time in jail for corruption, for stealing from the people of Karnataka. On the other side, Reddy brothers, who have stolen as much money from Karnataka as the Congress party gave for Narega. 35,000 crores. People of Karnataka, the Reddy brothers have stolen 35,000 crores from you. They have stolen your money from your pockets and they have fleeced you. The Prime Minister needs to answer why in none of his speeches does he talk about the 8 seats he has given to the Reddy brothers, why he doesn't explain to the people of Karnataka why the Central Bureau of Investigation has become the Central Bureau of Illegal Mining and is being used to protect these people. These are the issues. And by the way, women's atrocities is an issue across India and we will continue to raise it.
Shri Bharat from Deccan Herald. If you can please pass on the mic. Ravi, it's on your right. He's on your right hand side. Sir, as you raise hands, I'll keep jotting down and we'll take as many questions as possible.
Hi, Rahul.
Where are you
here
now?
Here. Okay, hi. We've been following your...
How are you?
I'm good. I've been following your campaign since February, and you visited a number of temples, mutts, and religious places of religious worship. What was the message that you were trying to send out? And a related question is, you've also been quoting a lot of Basavanna. How do you respond to the allegation that the Congress government here divided the Lingayat community by according religious minority status?
So the first question, there are many, many different ways in which our people express themselves. And our people have multiple different beliefs. They have different religious beliefs. They have different linguistic beliefs. As a leader of a political party, it is my job to stand with them in their beliefs. So whoever invites me to whichever institution, I will go to. I will go to because I respect their perspective. But I will not go to a single institution that is involved in dividing, spreading hatred, spreading anger, and killing people. So that is my position on the religious institutions. Now, what's interesting is throughout the last 15 years, I have been visiting temples, I have been visiting mosques, I have been visiting gurdwaras, I have been visiting pretty much every religious institution I come across. For some reason, the BJP doesn't like this. For some reason, the BJP gets very uncomfortable when I go to a temple.
They've called you an election Hindu.
Yeah, I don't think they understand the meaning of the term Hindu. Because the term Hindu is a perspective, it's a viewpoint. And it is something that is in the heart, it is imbibed, and it lives with you throughout. So that statement, election Hindu, is a demonstration of how they view their religion. I don't view my religion like that. What was the second question? The Lingayat issue. There is a difference between helping a community express themselves, empowering a community, and crushing a community. What the BJP is busy doing with the Dalits, with the tribals, with the minorities, is crushing them, killing them, and humiliating them, and dividing the country. There's a big difference between the two. The Congress Party's perspective is we help people empower themselves. Thank you.
Our senior journalist, Shri Vijay Grover, I think he was here on the right side.
Because mainly the Delhi.
I'm from Bangalore. I have one question to you, Rahul.
Yeah.
The fact is, like, you know, we've discussed a lot about national politics. In the international arena, when dealing with China especially, we saw that, you know, you had tweeted once appreciating the Prime Minister's stance when he was going to Wuhan. And
appreciating,
talk about the Doklam issue.
Can you just hold the mic closer to you so
yeah.
I can hear you?
On the Doklam issue, you had wished him all support. But somehow we see that the Doklam issue continues to be debated, discussed.
I wish the Prime Minister support because he is the leader of our country. I expected the Prime Minister in China to go as the leader of our country and stand right there and tell the Chinese and speak to them about Doklam. The Prime Minister went to China after the Chinese have entered Doklam and didn't mention a word about Doklam. He didn't say a word. The Prime Minister had a conversation with the Chinese president with no agenda. Are you telling me there's no agenda? There is an agenda. It's called Doklam. There is an agenda. It's called the Maldives. There is an agenda. It's called Nepal. Of course there's an agenda. What does he mean by going to China and having a discussion without an agenda? The agenda is, we are surrounded on all sides. That's the agenda. It's pretty clear. But you guys don't like to raise that. I don't know why.
No.
You guys are uncomfortable.
You think
guys
he's not been able to take it the way it should have been taken up?
Absolutely not. Our foreign policy has been decimated. Our foreign policy has been completely decimated. Across the board. And it's because the Prime Minister views foreign policy as an individual exercise. He's under the impression that he can go and have a personal conversation with the President of China or the President of Nepal and everything will magically happen. There are huge forces involved in this and the Prime Minister needs to take into account the extremely talented people who are sitting in the Foreign Ministry. The Prime Minister needs to carry his own people with him. Are there any conversations going on with the finance minister, with the defense minister about this type of strategy? No. It's a one-man show.
Shri Pramod from TV9.
Since the mic was not coming to a Kannada media hand, I'm
taking it. I would request, sir, I will come to you. Of course, I know you so well. Certain discipline all of us will have to maintain. And I assure you, Congress president, chief minister, and other leaders will take as many questions as possible. They are not like the current Prime Minister who doesn't address a PC. Can we go to...
I'm very passionate about this China issue. Let me tell you, in my view, the central challenge in front of our country today is our ability to give jobs to our youngsters. That's the central challenge. China is a competitor of ours. China is also a rising power. We are in an environment where we have to manage our foreign policy with extreme care. And I'm very passionate when I see fundamental blunders being made. Fundamental blunders. I saw a video recently of the Pakistani Republic Day parade with Chinese troops marching in it.
What does that tell you? I see complete change in the position of Russia with regards to India. I see the Russians supplying Pakistan with weapons which they've never done before. So there is a disaster that has been created on the foreign policy front. And it is, frankly, it is very dangerous for this country. That is why you're hearing sort of slightly louder expression from my side.
TV9, Shri Pramod.
Hello, sir. This is Pramod from TV9. I have a question that you have conducted the cycle yatra in Kolar against the petrol price hike. And you have also accused the Modi government of fleecing the common man. And don't you think they are following the UPS policy? And my another important question is, what is your stand on Mahdai? On the one hand, government of Karnataka is trying to solve the issue, but Goa Congress is protesting against that. And BJP, still referring to Sonaji's comment she has made during the election campaign, that is favorable for Goa. So what is your stand on Mahdai issue, and what is AICC stand? Can you clarify?
The petrol issue is very simple. The policy of the Congress party was to give benefits of the petroleum products, of the price of petroleum to our people. During the Congress regime, the price of petrol was $140 a barrel. Today that price is hovering around $70 a barrel. Huge amount of money is being saved by the government of India. The government of India can choose who to give that money to. The Congress party spent that money in schemes like Narega, schemes like farm loan waiver, which were pro-people schemes. The BJP has simply taken that money, lakhs of crores, and given it to their friends. So absolutely the policy is the same, but who you give the money to is completely different. There is massive amount of money that is coming, and that should be distributed. On the other issue, it is up to the Prime Minister to resolve that issue. Whatever resolution comes out, we support. That the issue should be resolved as soon as possible, fairly.
Maya Sharmaji. Right there, just behind. I can see her sitting there. Okay, thank you.
Maya Sharma from NDTV. You've spoken about the personal attacks being made by Prime Minister Modi. And there have been many, whether it's...
You agree with that there have been many personal attacks. Do you like the tone of those attacks? As an individual, do you like the tone? Do you like to see your politics being reduced to that?
It has been very interesting to see the level of debate and the level of comments being made by the Prime Minister. Both sides have
Do you appreciate the nature of those comments?
Both sides have made...
You're scared to say it? Don't worry, I'll let you off.
Both sides have, of course, been making personal attacks. But Prime Minister Modi has, of course, targeted you in many, many ways. Whether it's making fun of your response to a person here in Bengaluru saying that if the Congress did get a majority, you would be ready to become Prime Minister. And also, although it's an old one, your Italian ancestry, whether saying that you could debate in your mother's language or mentioning your mother's maiden name when she came to campaign here in North Karnataka. How do you respond to this? Not just as Congress president, but as an individual, as a human being. Your question to me, I'm asking you.
I can respond with the story. If you want me to respond with the story, I can respond with the story. Many years ago in this country, Buddha was sitting with his disciples. A person came and started abusing him, shouting at him, saying nasty things to him. And after about very abusive language, nasty stuff, and then after about an hour or two, the person left. So Buddha's disciples said to Buddha that, what have you done? This man has come to you, he's abused you, shouted at you. Why didn't you respond? And Buddha said, you see, the thing is, he got me the gift of anger. I didn't want it. I didn't take it. After some time, he went away. So Mr. Modi has anger inside him. And he's got anger for everybody, not only for me. I am a lightning rod of that anger. I attract that anger because he sees a threat from me. But his anger is his problem. It's not my problem. My problem is how to help the people of this country. Thank you.
But any response you'd like to give to that whole Italian origin, which is being used as a...
My mother is Italian. My mother has also lived
larger part of her life in India. She's more Indian than many, many Indian people I see. My mother has sacrificed for this country. My mother has suffered for this country. And it shows the quality of the Prime Minister when he makes these type of comments. It shows the quality of the man. And I'm happy to let him do so. If he enjoys himself, if he likes it, welcome. Have a nice day.
Well, Deepa on the right side. Can you kindly pass on the mic to her? Yes, sir, I've noted that.
So Deepa from CNN News 18. Sir, a couple of questions. One is, we are seeing about 20-plus union ministers coming here today on the last day of campaign. What do you have to say about the deluge of the, BJP's top leadership here in Karnataka? Secondly...
I'll spell it for you. P-A-N-I-C.
Okay.
Panic. They are panicked because now they are noticing and realizing that the Congress Party is doing things differently. The Congress Party showed them what it was capable of in Gujarat. And now the Congress Party has clearly demonstrated to them what it is capable of in Karnataka. I'm happy that as many of their ministers that would like to come can come. Frankly, it helps us because this is a fight between the spirit of Karnataka and the RSS. We are very clear. We don't want a barrage of leaders from outside this state to come here and fight for us. We are depending on our extremely solid leadership from Karnataka, and we are raising the voice of the people of Karnataka. You see, what is actually happening here, and this is something, my friends in Karnataka, you have to realize. The RSS is trying to take over your state. The RSS is attacking Basavanna. It is attacking your language, it is attacking your culture, it is attacking your wonderful food that you fed me so much that I've put on a little bit of weight. It is trying to decimate your way of life, and we will not allow it to do so. We are standing with you, and we will fight them off, and we will make sure that the voice of Basavanna and the idea and the spirit of this state lives large. Thank you.
You know, 2 days back, you said that you...
Ma'am, I'll have to take one question. There are too many friends waiting.
Just one question.
If you don't mind, Atatullahji is also waiting. Ma'am has been waiting.
I've already answered that question. I've already answered the question. The Prime Minister wants to distract. He wants to distract. The Prime Minister wants to distract the people of Karnataka. He talks about personal attack, you know, he talks about all sorts of different things except what the people of Karnataka actually want to hear, which is what are they going to do for that development? What are they going to do for the farmers? What are they going to do for the youngsters? The 2 crore youngsters that the Prime Minister promised jobs to. They are standing in lines in the rest of the country, jobless. In Karnataka, we have the record of the largest number of jobs in the country. This state produced the largest number of jobs in this country. Thanks to whom? Thanks to the Congress Party and the spirit of Basavanna. So I'm not going to get distracted by the Prime Minister. I've now learned to deal with him. When he realizes that he's coming into a space where there's no escape, then he distracts and he creates anger. We're not going to let him distract, and we're not going to let him create anger. We're going to defeat the BJP here.
Nahida ji here on this side, can you please pass on the mic?
Yesterday Modi said that fear of losing elections, there is a possibility of the Congress will rig the elections.
A man says what is inside his heart all the time. Whenever there's something, you watch Mr. Prime Minister, and you will notice that what comes out of his mouth is what's actually in his heart. He's absolutely convinced now, and he's right, that he's going to lose Karnataka, he's going to lose Chhattisgarh, he's going to lose Madhya Pradesh, he's going to lose Rajasthan, and he's going to lose 2019.
We have Raghavanji on that side. Can you please pass on the mic?
Sir, I'm Raghavan from India TV.
Yeah.
just want to, now, do you believe that the election in Karnataka, this election will strengthen your chances for 2019? And what are your thoughts? What are, as you said, that want to become prime minister. See, what are your chances of becoming prime minister in 2019?
I again want to state this. This election is not about me. And this election is not about the prime minister. This election is about the spirit of Karnataka. This state has given our country so much. When I hear that Karnataka, that Bengaluru is the second Silicon Valley, I feel proud. And I'm absolutely convinced that 5-10 years from today, actually the people of Silicon Valley will come and say, we are the second Silicon Valley and Bengaluru is the first. So this election is about respecting the spirit of the people of this state and giving them the things that they require to take the state forward and this country forward. I believe in the people of Karnataka. And I think it is disrespectful to have the type of discussions that our Prime Minister has when it comes to this election. I would expect the Prime Ministers to say, listen, let's talk about how we can help the farmers of Karnataka. Let's talk about, this is what you've done. This is what we are proposing. Let's talk about how we get jobs to all these young, brilliant people, youngsters in this state. You have suggested this. My party is suggesting this. We have put a manifesto out. We've clearly said, have any conversation you want with us. Let's talk about farmers. Let's talk about IT. Let's talk about the Garden City. Right? But that conversation is not forthcoming. And frankly, it's insulting to the youngsters. It's insulting to the youngsters when the Prime Minister comes and tries to make this election about me or, you know, something ridiculous. No. So, we are very patient. We will not engage along those lines. But I want to tell the youngsters of Karnataka that we are going to make sure that the jobs that you're looking for, they are available to you in this state. We have done it over the last 5 years, and we're going to do it. And we're going to do it so aggressively that the rest of the country will stand up and take notice. The world will stand up and take notice. I think we're done on time.
Shri Shankar from Udaywani is here. He's been saying, and if we can take one question from Shuddhi TV. Sir, I will.
So Karnataka election, my friend.
Can we please pass on the mic?
Excuse me. Would you like to ask a question? Please ask a question.
Mr. Gandhi?
No, the gentleman is saying.
Mr. Gandhi, I'm here.
So let the gentleman ask and then we'll come to you.
Yeah.
Hello, sir.
Well, actually, I let me answer.
So, can you ask question instead of making let me ask a question.
Let me answer your question. Congress Party has given tremendous support to Bengaluru infrastructure. The pressure is tremendous because, fortunately for us, Bengaluru has now become interesting to the whole world. So, there is tremendous amount of pressure. We will continue to support the city. On the details, I don't want to suggest to the state government what I think they should do. I think we have the chief minister sitting here, so I will rather that he tells you what the state government is going to do.
Mr. Gandhi?
I think there was a question already being asked.
Mr. Gandhi,
ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಇಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೆ ಸುಮಾರು 13,000 ಕೋಟಿ ರೂಪಾಯಿಗಳನ್ನು ಮಂಜೂರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಈಗಾಗಲೇ ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಕೆಲಸಗಳು ಕೂಡ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಆಗಿದ್ದಾವೆ. ನಾವು ಮಂಜೂರು ಮಾಡಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೆಲಸಗಳು ಕೂಡ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರೆಸ್. ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ನಗರದ ಸ್ವರೂಪ ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ನೀವೇ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಇನ್ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಸಿಟಿ.
Can we now permit Shri Shankar to ask
with
the cumulative permission? Sir, this
sir.
Is unfair.
One second.
Well, now we have a... To we have supersede other colleagues like Mr. that, somebody is already Mr. asking the Mr. question.
Sir. Hello, sir. This is Shankar Pabuji.
Sir, this is very unfair, sir.
One second. Mr. Sirjewala, you don't know my name. That's why you're not calling me out. But I am here. I am Anant, editor of News 8 in Kannada. I wanted to ask you about a post-poll scenario.
Sir, I thought News 18 also already took a question and there was a gentleman
News 8 in Kannada hasn't taken a question. News 8 in Kannada hasn't taken a question. Just a second. I want to jump to a post-poll scenario. You know, all pre-poll surveys indicate that we are heading towards a hung assembly. You may say you're confident of getting a majority. That's, you know, while appreciating that, I would also like to know, in case there is a hung assembly scenario, are you open to tying up with anyone, any party, including the JDS? Let me complete my question. Yeah. There is one more thing to it. Including JDS, are you ready to tie up with any party? And if such a party insists that there be a Dalit chief minister, are you open to that?
In Gujarat, my friends in the media said that the Congress party will not get more than 20, 30 seats. The Congress party came very close to defeating the BJP in Gujarat. Prime Minister put whatever effort he could. I'm pretty clear here that there is only one outcome here. And that outcome is that the Congress party is going to win this election hands down. And I'll tell you why. Because this has now become an election between two ideologies. This is no longer an election between simply two political parties. On one side, you have the RSS idea of one concept on top of this whole country. And on the other side, you have the idea that every single person in India should be able to express himself. That all my friends in Karnataka should have pride in their language, that they should have pride in their food, that they should have pride in the things they do. That's what this fight has become. And it is a one-way answer. There is no halfway answer possible in this. And the answer is going to be, we are for Basavanna. Thank you.
No, you spoke
thank
about
you so
Canada.
Much.
You spoke about Canada. One second. You spoke about Canada.
There's one last question, which I know I was expecting, but
thankfully,
you didn't.
Thankfully, Canada has come to the forefront in this election. Other than making it a symbolic gesture, would you go out and amend the constitution so that Kannadigas can write central competitive exams in Canada?
Look, I'm making a broad statement. They tell me it's already there. Anyway, let me move ahead. There is an idea in India that says the entire country must be ruled with one idea, one imposition. It says that everybody in India must submit to that idea. That is what the RSS is trying to do. You didn't ask me about the Supreme Court, but I'd like to talk about it. Institution after institution is being attacked by the RSS. Supreme Court judges for the first time are asking the Indian people for justice. There is a reason for this. The reason is that the RSS is placing their people everywhere. And the idea is to crush, my friends in Karnataka, listen to this carefully. The idea is to crush your spirit, and we will never ever allow your spirit and the ideas of Basavanna to be crushed. Thank you very much.